Hey gamers, welcome back to the channel, and boy have we got a treat in store for you today. We are taking a look at Fortnite Chapter 4 for one very special reason. Obviously, we know that with a new chapter in Fortnite, it brings new additional content, but that is not why we're here today, because today we're taking a look at the most innovative features delivered via Unreal Engine 5.1 that are now available in Fortnite. With Unreal Engine 5, it absolutely delivers a generational leap in fidelity and bringing an unprecedented level of detail to the gaming world in Fortnite like we've never ever seen before. They've brought things like Nanite, Lumen and Virtual Shadow Maps, and they're all available in Fortnite now across each of the platforms on PlayStation 5, Series X, PC and of course cloud gaming. Now there's some pretty darn fancy words, and what does it all mean? Now the easy thing to do would be to say, look at the screen, watch the video, and you will see a clear marked difference in the way Fortnite performs and the actual visual fidelity, and everything in the world just looks so much better than it ever has. Quite honestly, Fortnite has never looked so good. Now coming up in a second, I will show you the settings menu and how to take advantage of this on GeForce Now so that you can really extract the best out of Fortnite and these new changes they've delivered. But first, I'm going to give you the technical explanations direct from Epic on what these fancy words actually mean and where you will see the changes in the environments and surroundings when you are playing Fortnite. Now first up is this fancy word, Nanite. Nanite essentially provides a highly detailed architectural geometry, specifically with buildings that are now rendered from millions of polygons in real time. And each brick, stone, wood plank and wall trim is modelled. Natural landscapes are also exceptionally high detailed, with individual trees featuring no less than 300,000 polygons. And each stone, flower and blade of grass is modelled. Now that essentially means that as we encounter each of the buildings, surroundings and the overall environment within Fortnite, it is going to be much more detailed than we've ever been able to see before. And it's really leveraging the power of Unreal Engine 5 and pushing that gaming technology forward, delivering the best experience, whilst it still being the trusty battle royale that you've come to know and love. Next up is Lumen. Now Lumen Reflections you will be very familiar with if you have a current generation console, a high-end PC with an RTX graphics card, or even are accustomed to GeForce Now already on either the Priority or 3080 tier. Lumen Reflections provide high quality ray trace reflections on glossy materials and water. It also delivers global illuminations and allows you to run all of this whilst maintaining performance at 60 frames per second. So those interior spaces where light bounces and it gives you those recreation of the way the light would actually interact in those spaces. You'll see light scattered onto nearby objects and surfaces and also reacting with your character as they react to the surroundings around them. The next one is nice and simple, and that is Virtual Shadow Maps. That effectively allows for highly detailed shadowing, meaning that each brick, leaf or any model detail will cast a shadow, and now you will see that character self-shadowing is extremely accurate. The final change introduced is with regards to temporal super resolution, also known as TSR, and this is a very simple one because it effectively allows high quality visuals at a high frame rate, meaning you can get the best quality from the game but maintain those frames, allowing you to be as competitive as possible in this battle royale. It is worth noting at this point that whilst Fortnite does support Nvidia DLSS, they have confirmed that it is currently disabled whilst they test it with the latest Unreal 5.1 feature update, which has now been introduced into Fortnite. Now Fortnite is still the game that you love and enjoy to play, and that hasn't changed. The only difference is it has never looked so good. And whilst we've managed to maintain 4K 60, I've found that the best way to experience this is to absolutely set this to 1440, turn those settings up, and you will manage to average around 90 FPS. Now on to the next bit. How do you enable those settings and how does it behave in order to get the best from Fortnite? We're going to jump in and show you where to change those settings, what to look for, and then you'll be ready and set to get on your way to enjoy Fortnite in the best possible way. The first thing that you have to do once you've booted in is go into the settings menu and then hit into the settings from here. Go to rendering mode. It will be set to DX11. Change this to DX12. Now you'll notice as you scroll down, some of those new options that we've mentioned are either grayed out or disabled. Click apply and it will tell you you need to restart. Once it's restarted, you will see the rendering mode will be set to DirectX 12. You will then have Nanite virtualized geometry available to turn on and virtual shadows. Set the virtual shadows to high, global illumination to Lumen High, along with reflections, and leave the rest of the settings as they are, and make sure that you hit apply, and this will put you in a place where you are able to maximize at 4K 60, or alternatively set it to 1440 120 and take advantage of averaging at 90 FPS and that improved performance over the 60 FPS in 4K resolution. That's it in terms of the update and how to extract the best out of Fortnite on GeForce Now. We will leave you to enjoy some of the remaining gameplay, but the only thing that remains to be said is we think that this update for Fortnite is absolutely incredible. It cannot be understated enough, and it truly does push the boundaries of what we can expect to see in games as we move forward, leveraging the power of Unreal Engine 5. Thank you very much for watching our content. We hope you've enjoyed it. And we'll now leave you with the remainder of this battle royale so you can see where we placed. Catch you next time.